Okay, the first thing to do after creating your team is to start finding a sponsor. Click on sponsor and find your sponsor. Sponsors have different advantages. You can either get a sponsor that has a high initial payment, or sponsors that have a high weekly payment, or a high payment for your victories. Up here you can sort how you want to find your sponsor. For example, you can say weekly and you can get the highest weekly rate, or you could say initial, and then here's an initial payment of 4 million euro, but the weekly is not that high, so it's a matter of how you want to, which kind of sponsorship you want. So let's try to take this Sun Limited sponsorship, sign sponsor. Now we have signed the sponsor, we have received the 4 million euros, and we will get 6,000 euros per week, so it's not a big amount of money, but we have got a lot of money to start with. The next thing to do is to go into your office, and in your office you can obtain loan because it's good to have some funds. Now we have quite good amount of fund, but we can try to take a loan in, let's say, in 1 million euros, obtain loan, and now we have obtained the loan of 1 million euro, and we have 7 million euros to get players. Next thing to do is go into transfer. Oh, and first go into your team. In your team, you can see your team. Your current team is not very good. You always start with a quite bad team, but this is where you can build up your own team. Go into transfer, and in transfer, you can see that all the players available for transfer currently is. There's a lot of players orange, and that means that they are too good for your team. So what you can do is you can click a likable, and here you can see that there's still orange players, but those orange players is players that can get you your team, but they will demand a higher salary. But let's try to find, for example, some a new forward player, and you do that by clicking forward up here. And now you can see there's a lot of players available. Your best forward player has 29 in skill, and you want to have a better player. So let's try to, for example, there's a player here that has, it's actually not that expensive. And you click his name on his name, and you can see some more details about the player, and then you can make an offer. You can also raise the offer, but it shouldn't be necessary on this type of player. So let's go back in and click here, and then this is not the one I want. I want this player because this player is the only thing about this player. He is 31 years old, so I would actually recommend doing the 20 years old player. He's a bit more expensive, but he's young, so he will be able to stay at the team for a longer time. Also look at the star rating. The star rating will tell you how good the player is over time. So if you, for example, get a player that has a silver star, then he has a potential of getting his skill improved up to 95%. 95. The best kind of players, that is the gold players. You can click talent, and then you will see only the gold players that's currently available. It's a very good thing to get the gold players because they will r race quickly in skill, and that is also players that you will actually be able to use when you advance your in divisions. You always start in Division 4. So let's try this, for example, to make a bid on David Gray. So over here you can see you have made two bids on Kian Johnson and David Gray. Now we also meet some midfield players. I will only go for the star players. You can see that this player has a flame, and that means that other teams is currently bidding on this player, so it will be a little difficult to get him. But let's disable the team and only find the best midfielders, and let's go for this Jan Richter. I'll make an offer on him. So we can also get some a good defense player. And you can see Oliver Linn is the could be a good player to get. Click on Oliver Linn and make an offer on him. Now we have made these offers, we also need a good keeper. And you can see there's a lot of keepers available here. And actually, I would try to get this keeper because this keeper has a gold star. He's 19 years old, there's very good potential on this keeper. There's a little dot, which means that there's some bets on this player. So let's click this player and make an offer on him. So now we have all these offers. And the thing is that that will, it will take some time before the teams will look at your bids and tell you if you get the player. Inside your inbox, you can see you will receive emails telling whether you get the player or not. So now we have made the bids in the transfer. In this game, you can do transfers all the time. You don't need to wait for there's not a closed transfer period. You can buy players all the time to improve your team. The next thing you need to do is now you can go to your team, and here you can see all the available strategies that you can choose from. This is a 4-4-2, which is a very generic setup of how your team plays with the two forward players, four midfielders, and four defensive players. When you get your new players, you need to click on Auto Set All Players, and the assistant coach will select only the best players for the team. If you scroll a little bit down, you can see that you have also some substitutes, which is very important because the players will get worse during the match, so they need to replace players during the match. You can see in this overview that there's a lot of players that have red numbers under this STA, and that means that their stamina is really bad and they will run out of energy really quick. To improve that, you will need to go into training. Now that the screen has changed, that's because sometime the day will advance, and that happens once each hour. And the day will advance. That's also where we will be able to see if we get some of the players that we have made bids on. It can take up to even up to 30 days to get a player in-game days, because the players if players are very popular in the transfer, there will be a lot of teams continuously bidding, and it can be difficult to get the player. So you need to wait until you will be able to get the player. But in this training, you can see that there's this stamina. You have these training days, you have the match day, and then you have 6 training days. And overall, it's just that the players will just overall improve a little bit. But this stamina thing will make sure that the players will improve their stamina, so they will be a bit better to last longer and get in matches. Don't put too many. If you put stamina all through the training program, the players will get extremely tired, and at match day they will not be able to last very long. So it's very important that you only have one or maximum two of these during a training session. This little bar below shows that this is the current day. So the next tomorrow it will be overall, and then I put a rest day right before the match because rest will get their energy up, and you can see here in this column that you have the energy. But let's see what happens. We have got 5 mails in inbox. You can see the little 5. It says that you are outbid by Landskrona, so there's another team that has outbid you, actually on quite some of the players, and this player is declining your offer because the offer is a little bit higher than your offer. So but we get this player. Fallon accepted your offer on Oliver Linn. So that's great. And now we can go into our team, your team, And we can see that our new player, let's find him, he's down here. He's a defense player, and he is now available for your team. You can set auto set, and you can see that his place here in the formation. We can also start selling out players. It can be very difficult to sell these players because they are basically too bad. So it's actually better to fire them directly. This player, he's not that bad because he has a silver star, so he has a potential of getting better. So I wouldn't sell him, but I could sell this Harvey Murray, and I would actually fire him because he will not be able to. We will not be able to sell him. So fire the player, and now he's fired. I also want to fire this player. The reason why I fire the players is because you have to pay salary for the players. So to not get in economical issues, you need to keep firing your players. If you go to dashboard, you can see that the next match is played in 36 minutes, or in 4 in-game days. So in 36 minutes, the match will be played, and we are Blackpool, and we will play again Eastbourne. And we are playing away. If you scroll down on the dashboard, you can also see that there's a lot of information. Like you can see here the division standing, you can see your inbox and your latest news.